Hello guys, this is Prem Nidhi Sharma presenting Oracle GoldenGate Integrated Extract. It is one of the more interesting and useful features. In the integrated capture mode, the Oracle GoldenGate Extract process interacts directly with a log mining server to receive data changes in the form of logical change record, that is called LCR, logical change record. But in the classic capture mode, the Oracle GoldenGate Extract process captures data changes from the Oracle redo or archive log files on the source system. So that means there's a difference. Integrated extract always read the LCR format, and classic extract read the data from the redo log file or archive log file. So let's move to the other slide, next slide. So integrated capture supports two types of deployment configuration: on-source capture and downstream capture. Let's discuss about this slide first. So this is the source database. The change vector information is retrieved from the source database and shipped to the redo log files. In the same machine, this is talking about the same machine. So from the redo log file, the data converted into the LCR format, and integrated capture read the LCR format and ship the data over the network to the remote tray. That is called remote file or remote tray. Remote file is generally used in the initial load, and tray is used in the capture mode. So this is the same machine, and integrated capture read the data from the LCR and ship over the network to the remote tray file. So there's a two mode: on source capture, and the second one is called downstream capture. On source capture, the capture process is started on the actual source. That means the on source capture is started on the actual source database server itself. Changes as they happen on source database will be captured locally, routed, transformed, and applied on target database in near real time. That means, suppose let's take example, there is a two database, Amir and Euro. Amir is at source side and Euro is target side. So the on-source capture, that means the capture information will be taken from the Amir database here and shipped, routed over the network to the Euro database. So as we discussed, there's a two mode: on-source capture and downstream capture. So on-source we have discussed. Now come to the downstream capture. So downstream capture, GoldenGate downstream deployment allow you to offload the source database extract load to intermediate or target server. The source database ships its redo log to downstream database and extract using the log miner server as a downstream database to mine the redo log. A downstream mining database can accept both archive log and online redo log from the source database. We can see here source database, redo log, and redo log ship data over the network to the downstream machine. Now this is the downstream machine, and in the downstream machine this is called standby redo log. This is for redo log and this is called standby redo log. So that means we have to use the data guard technology to ship the redo log to the standby redo log and the logical change record. Then the standby redo log is converted into the LCR format so that integrated extract read the LCR format and write into the remote tray. So this is called real time. In the downstream machine, there's a real time and non-real time. In this method, there's a two type of mining as I discussed. First one is real time, the second one is non-real time. In real time downstream capture environment, the primary database is configured so that the transport service uses the log writer process, that's for LGWR, log writer process, at the source database to send redo data to the downstream database either synchronously or asynchronously. That means the redo log writer ship data to the standby redo log synchronously or asynchronously. The other option that is called non-real time is called, we don't need standby redo log in the downstream database. For this configuration or in this option, downstream extract is not configured for real time capture. It waits for next archive log. That means when the log switch occurred on the source database, the archive log will be generated. So we can see log redo log, when its log switch occurred, the data which is from the redo log file shipped to this location and it converted into the LCR format. Integrated capture read the LCR format and write to the trail file, that's the remote trail file. Let's see how to convert from classic capture to integrated capture. So there is some certain commands to convert to classic capture to integrated capture. First of all, we have to stop the extract process. So this is the command to stop the extract process. That is stop process name ext blast. So this is the command to stop extract. Now in the second point or second option, we have to register extract. Suppose ext blast is the name of the extract process database. We have to execute this command to register the extract process at the replicate site. Same thing we have to done at replicate site, at the replicate site. So first we have to replicate the process. Stop list, and then filter replicate list integrated. So we have to execute this command. First we have to stop the extract process, that is ext blast, and then we have to register the extract process. At the replicate site, same thing, we have to stop the list, and then alter replicate list integrated we have to convert. After that, at store side, I have to start, or before we, what we can do, at the source side, we have to upgrade the classic extract, the integrated classic extract to the integrated. Alter extract ext west, and then we have to execute upgrade command, upgrade integrated translog, so that the extract process will be upgraded to the integrated. Now after that, what we can do, start asterisk at the source side, this is at source side, at source side, and at the target side asterisk, or we can use the process name extract or replicate process name, we can use instead of that. So this is called integrated extract, real time and non real time. Thank you for watching my video.